Thanks for nothing on my 70th birthday. I want to give my thanks to everyone for everything. And as a token of my appreciation, I want to offer back to you all my good and bad habits as magnificent, priceless jewels, wish-fulfilling gems, satisfying your every need and want. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thanks. May every drug I ever took come back and get you high. May every glass of wine and vodka I ever drank come back and make you feel really good, numbing your nerve ends, allowing the natural clarity of your mind to flow free. May all the suicides be songs of aspiration. Thanks, the bad news is always true. May all the chocolate I've ever eaten come back rushing through your bloodstream and make you feel happy. Thanks for allowing me to be a poet, a noble effort doomed but the only choice. I want to thank you for your kindness and praise. Thanks for celebrating me. Thanks for the resounding applause. Thanks for taking everything for yourself and giving nothing back. You were always only self-serving. Thanks for exploiting my big ego and making me a star for your own benefit. Thanks that you never paid me. Thanks for all the sleaze. Thanks for being mean and rude and smiling at my face. I am happy that you robbed me. I am happy that you lied. I am happy that you helped me. Thanks. Grazie. Merci beaucoup. May you smoke a joint with William and spend some intimate time with his mind, more profound than any book he wrote. I give enormous thanks to all my lovers, beautiful men with brilliant minds, great artists, Bob, Jasper, Hugo. May they come here and make love to you. And may my many other lovers of totally great sex, countless lovers of boundless, fabulous sex, countless lovers of boundless, fabulous sex, countless lovers of boundless, fabulous sex, in the golden age of promiscuity, may they all come here and make love to you, if you want. May they hold you in their arms, ballin' to your heart's delight, ballin' to your heart's delight, ballin' to your heart's delight. May all the people who are dead, Alan, Brian, Cookie, Jack, and I do not miss any of you. I don't miss any of them. No nostalgia. It was wonderful that we loved each other, but I do not want any of them back. Now, if any of you are attracted to any of them, may they come back from the dead and do whatever is your pleasure. May they multiply and be the slaves of whomever wants them, satisfying your every wish and desire. But you won't want them as masters, as their demons. May Andy come here, fall in love with you, and make each of you a superstar. Everyone can have an Andy, everyone can have an Andy, everyone can have an Andy, everyone can have an Andy. Huge hugs to my friends who betrayed me. Every friend became an enemy sooner or later. Deep kisses to my loves that failed. I am delighted you are vacuum cleaners, sucking everything into your dirt bag. You are none other than a reflection of my mind. Thanks for the depression problem and feeling like suicide every day of my life. And now that I'm 75, I'm happily almost there. 20 billion years ago, in the primordial wisdom soup, beyond comprehension and indescribable, something without substance moved slightly and became something imperceptible, moved again and became invisible, moved again and became a particle, and particles, and moved again and became a quark, and again and became quarks, moved again and became protons and neutrons and the 12 dimensions of space. Tiny fireballs of primordial energy, bits tossed back and forth in a game of catch between particles, transmitting electromagnetic light and going really fast, 40 million times a second. Where the pebble hits the water, this is where the trouble began. Something without substance became something with substance. Why did this happen? Because something substanceless had a feeling of missing out on something. Not getting it was not getting it. Not getting it. Not getting something when there was nothing to have. From that primordially endless potential to modern day reality, 20 billion years later, has produced me, and my stupid grasping mind has made me and you and my grasping mind. May Rinpoche and all the great Tibetan teachers who loved me come back and love you more. May they hold you in their wisdom hearts, bathe you in all pervasive compassion, give you pith instructions, and may you, with the diligence of Olympic athletes, do meditation practice, and may you, with great confidence, realize the true nature of mind. America, thanks for the neglect. I did it without you. Let us celebrate poetic justice. You and I never were, never tried to do anything, and never succeeded. Thanks for introducing me to the face of the naked mind. Thanks for nothing. Thank you.